Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Trendonomics by Harsh Dixit. So one more gap up and Mandarin continues. Kya chal raha hai market mein boss? I'm going to discuss about Nifty, Bank Nifty, broad market, gold, silver, dollar index. This is going to be an interesting video. Watch till end. But before that, I would like to thank you all. The weekend video got more than 3,000 views. So love you. Keep supporting us. If you are still new and haven't subscribed, subscribe to this free YouTube channel. Subscribe, share, like, comment, follow me on Twitter. This is my Twitter handle, @Harsh684, where I share stock market updates, live market updates. So to receive live market updates, you must follow me on Twitter. If you should learn Elliott Waves, we have a recorded webinar, Elliott Waves, where I have discussed all the patterns. Just for 999, yes, discounted price, I have discussed the patterns, multi-wave, corrective waves, how to spot opportunities in different asset classes, how to spot highest probability trading opportunities, identifying major turning points, riding big waves, gain confidence, improve your trading, how to use a combination of tools like moving average, RSI, Fibonacci, trendline, trend channels. Yes, we use traditional tools. Also discuss how to avoid the common mistake people do. I'm also giving this book by Frost and Practer, complete ebook. So just register for the webinar and you'll get all the resources. Register from the blog Trendonomics or from link in description or from the Twitter profile pinned to it. If you don't want to register, it's okay. I'm still sharing this free ebook by Frost and Practer. I have given the link in description, so just grab it. So let's discuss now markets. So as discussed, Nifty is into fifth wave. This is a clear five-wave rally from March lows and again from level of 10,790, we have a clear subdivision as 1, 2, 3, 4, and we are into fifth wave. We are into fifth of fifth. But where this run is likely to end or whether it wants to extend, yes, we are going to discuss that. We have a one more gap up. We have a doji close. Yes, we have a doji close or a star, doji star close. Will it be an evening star? If you don't know what is evening star, an evening star is a pattern in an uptrend where market opens gap up and closes almost near the opening with a very narrow body and a long tail. And then next day we have a gap down and follow up selling. That's an evening star reversal pattern. I'm not saying there will be an evening star pattern. Yes, definitely single candlestick does not constitute anything. As I have always been saying, we need a follow-up price action, definitely. So this is just one signal. I'm not saying it will reverse or not. We don't know, but definitely we'll discuss what are the probabilities. So as discussed, we are into fifth wave, we are into fifth of fifth, and we are looking for the answer whether this is going to extend further or it will reverse now from here on. So let's just go down onto the hourly chart. So until now, we had been discussing that there are a lot of overlaps. There are a couple of overlaps. And we said that probably this is an ending diagonal. And when we break down the swing lows, then we can expect a move down. But that's not happening. Yes, that's not happening yet. We are still not breaking swing lows or closing below the previous day low. So definitely, unless and until that happens, we are not going to reverse the trend. But yes, we are overbought now on hourly. We have RSI of about 75 or 76. And on daily also, we are, I think, have a RSI of about 78. So yes, pretty much overbought. We still have a negative divergence on daily. Despite this run up, yes, because of this 600 points down move. Now even this 600 points down move looks a small correction within this larger uptrend. Yes, when this 600 points drop came, yes, definitely it looked like a nightmare. Even this 500 points correction from 12,000 to 11,530, that looked like a nightmare. But yes, now this correction looks small. So now, what next? If the correction is coming now, definitely that will be a bigger correction. That is for sure. But when it will come? Well, we still cannot say precisely whether we have ended this rally or we are still going to extend. So we were discussing there are too many overlaps, and this looks like an ending diagonal. But in weekend video, prior to weekend video on Thursday, probably we discuss an alternate count. We discuss that if market wants to develop an wave extension, is there a possibility of wave extension? So I said that for that I need a vertical move, a vertical rally without any overlap, and then I will say that market wants to extend the move. So is market going to extend? Well, we still don't have a definite answer, because though we have this vertical up move from the low of 14,122, this is pretty much vertical, and this is clearly five wave move. This is a five wave move from the low of 14,122. But we still don't have a clear five wave cycle or a clear five wave move on a larger time frame from the low of 14,040. So till we don't get a five wave move from the swing low of 14,040, we cannot say that whether market wants to extend or market wants to reverse. But definitely we have a clear cut points or clear cut levels upon which we can decide whether market wants to extend or reverse. So this swing high of 14,256 is an important level, because if we are saying that this is wave one, and then we are into third wave, if we are saying that in case of a wave extension, so if we are saying this is wave one, and then we had a expanded flat correction in wave two, and from there we are getting a third wave extension, then definitely if this is the third wave, it has to develop as a five wave move. Until now we have only three wave move, that can be either ABC or that can be 1 2 3 4 5. So if we assume this is 1 2 and probably third wave completed today, we should have a fourth wave correction, and then again fifth wave, and then probably a third wave will get over. If we are assuming that, then any correction in wave four shall not overlap this high of 14,256. So far it looks like a five-way move from this low is over, so we might get a little correction, if not a big one. But in that case, a correction should not overlap this high of 14,256. If correction overlaps this high of 14,256, then we can certainly say that this is not a five-way move, or this is not a wave extension. And rather, this is an ending diagonal, and market is now going to reverse the trend. So 14,256 marks most important level to decide whether market wants to extend or market wants to reverse. And definitely it should break tomorrow, or max day after tomorrow, that's Wednesday. By Wednesday, it should break this level. Then we can say that probably we are going to reverse the trend. If it doesn't break, or rather if it doesn't overlap into this level, if it doesn't overlap into this high of 14,256, then definitely we will assume that market wants to extend the run. So market will have a little correction in wave four, then again wave five, that will complete third wave, and then again after a fourth wave correction, we'll have another rally in fifth wave, and then market will end this move from the low of 13,130, or overall fifth wave move. So precisely now we don't have a clear cut answer, but we have the point of 14,256. So keep watch on this level of 14,256. If it breaks tomorrow, then certainly this is an ending diagonal, and we should be going down from here. We should be going into correction. If it doesn't, then certainly market will extend the rally. and we can still keep stretching into this fifth wave until market reverses. There is one index, that's IT, which has a bigger weightage in Nifty. That's the only factor which gives a hope that probably market would reverse tomorrow onwards. So we had been discussing IT's into fifth wave from the lows of March. And again, the fifth wave is extending. And we were discussing that IT has done a wave four correction last week, and it's now into final fifth wave. And probably today that wave is over now. And then if this wave is over, a five-wave rally is over, then definitely we should get a correction, a deeper correction in IT stocks. We have a negative divergence. This is an hourly chart. Even on daily chart, we have a negative divergence. And we can clearly see a five-wave rally, which might be ending in IT stocks. We have this resistance of trend channel. This is IT index. So if IT stocks come down, IT has a good weightage in index. So that's the only factor which can drive Nifty down, and maybe then we can expect a reversal, a trend reversal. So again, IT has a gap up and it's closing higher. It's not a evening star, but if we have a gap down and run down, then definitely we can expect a reversal in IT. A five-wave move is getting over. So definitely after a five-wave move, we should get a correction. But only when this swing low of 25,170 breaks, then we can certainly say that yes, this IT rally is over and we should be getting a deeper correction now. So IT is the one index that might pull down Nifty. So but Nifty is a weighted index. We still have to wait for that low of for that swing high of 14,256 to break to say that yes, we are going for a reversal. In Bank Nifty, we don't have a clear answer. So we discussed that Bank Nifty is into fifth wave. And again, probably this is wave one and two. And we have mostly now completed third. And we might be in fourth wave correction. And it still looks like a fifth wave high is pending. If it's not already done as of today with a fifth wave truncation like this, yes. Maybe this is one and two, then third wave we've got over here and a small fourth wave correction and fifth truncation. That's one possibility. Or if not, then maybe a fourth wave is getting over and we should have a fifth wave rally. So on banks, we don't have a clear answer. But IT, mostly fifth wave is over. Again, in Nifty Auto Index, in auto, we still don't have a clear answer. Auto index is into fifth wave. And we discussed that probably the rally is still extending. We don't have a clear cut answer whether the fifth wave is getting over. Either it's wave one and two, and then we have an extended third wave, which is still going on. So it looks like the run-up in auto stock, it's still not over, maybe, unless and until we break some important swing lows, that is now 9684, or rather the swing high of 9525, unless and until we break it. We cannot precisely say whether the rally in auto stocks is over. So auto is still looking bullish. It's still not bearish. Metals, however, giving a signal of weakness or a trend change. So as we discussed, metal is into fifth wave and it has given a super run from this wave four low. We have a clear five wave rally, wave one, two, and then extended third wave. And after fourth wave correction, again, we can clearly see a five wave rally. And today we got a little breakdown of this trend channel. Yes, but unless and until it breaks and closes below this swing low, that is 3454, we cannot precisely say whether this rally is over. But yes, if it breaks, then we can say that fifth wave in metal is over and we should be going for a correction. So again, metals is another index which might lead Nifty down. So wait and watch for a bearish signal in metal stocks. And mid-cap index, Nifty mid-cap. Again, it looks like we're still into fifth wave. And again, today we have a little weakness in mid-cap index. We have a hammer close. In mid-caps. So still we don't have answer. We are into fifth wave. And when we break this all-time highs, previous all-time high, then probably we can say that fifth wave is over. The dollar index, we had been discussing dollar index. We said that probably a five-wave move down in dollar index is getting over. And now it looks like it's over now because we have got a breakout of this trend channel and it is sustaining above it. So mostly the dollar index has done the move down or down move. A five wave down move is now clearly looks to be over in the dollar index and it should be going for a reversal. And if dollar goes for a pullback rally, then certainly equities would be going for a pullback correction. That is a correction in wave two because equity is showing a five-wave rally and dollar is showing a five-wave move down. So dollar has completed first wave of downtrend. Yes, definitely this dollar bear market is going to stay for another few years, but if we are looking in terms of short term, definitely a wave two pullback rally is on cards. So if I'm looking on a monthly chart, this is just a first wave. We have a good support. We have a very important support on dollar index near the level of 89. And a pullback rally or wave two correction is on cards. In terms of long term, definitely we have much more down to go in dollar index. So in terms of long term, definitely equities have much more bull run to go. But in terms of short term, definitely first phase of the bull market is near getting over. I'm still not saying that it's over because we still need some breakdowns. But in dollar, we certainly can see a trend reversal coming up in dollar index. So in dollar, I can say that five-wave move down is mostly over and we should be going for a big trend reversal. And yes, definitely we cannot directly correlate equities to dollar, but definitely a pullback rally in dollar will have a negative impact on equities. So somehow, if not immediately, it will give an effect until the equities doesn't complete the five-wave rally. It may keep stretching, but eventually we will have a wave two correction in equities. We will definitely have that correction. But from which level or which day, that is still uncertain. That answer we are still trying to find. So a pullback in dollar is definitely going to give a weakness in equities. We saw that gold had a weakness, gave a sharp drop. So earlier we discussed that mostly the fourth wave correction in gold is over and We should be going for a WaveFire rally, but definitely we will have to review this because the breakout has failed. Breakout has failed, and if the dollar is going for a pullback rally, then I'll have to again review whether gold is going for gold and silver, both bullion precious metals are going for a run up, or it will continue to lag and give a sideways correction. So far, as of now, it still have a probability that we might have just completed first wave, as wave 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then maybe we have an ABC correction in gold, and we might have a third wave. But again, if I am saying dollar is going for a bull run, then I don't know how gold and silver will go up. So I will not be convincingly saying that this is wave 1 and 2 and we should be going for a third wave. So I will have to review unless and until gold again starts giving back the rally. But this is one probability. This is one probability that maybe we have completed wave 1 and 2 in gold and we should be going for a third wave. But again, the dollar, if dollar is going to be strengthened, then we'll have to review this view. Again, in silver, this probably looks like we have done a five-wave rally, a first five-wave rally in silver as wave 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then maybe this is just an ABC correction, a wave 2 correction. Again, we'll have to review this because if dollar is going for a pullback rally, then definitely usually it has a negative impact on both equity and precious metals. So either this is wave 1 and 2 or this is just a pullback rally in a larger correction and then it might continue to go down. So I'm not very much sure about gold and silver. I'll have to review this, but dollar, I'm pretty much sure, very much confident that dollar mostly completed this five-wave move down and we should be going for a corrective rally in next 2 to 3 months till March to April and precisely towards the level of 96 or this trend line from where we had a breakdown. Now we have a resistance. So if dollar is going for a pullback, ideally it should test this trend line or a pullback for wave 2 and then it shall continue its move down. That's my view. This is just first wave in dollar index. We'll have a pullback rally in wave 2 and then the downtrend will continue. But if we are having a pullback rally for next 2 to 3 months or maybe 4 months, then definitely equities will be negatively impacted. So Dow Jones again, we discussed that it's a five-wave rally from March lows and we are into fifth wave. So if a dollar is going for a pullback, then definitely a Dow Jones will give a pullback in wave 2. The wave counts are still not clear in Dow, whether this is 1, 2, 3, 4 and fifth wave or something else. But in Nifty, we have a clear-cut waves we can clearly see that this is a five-wave move from the lows of March, where we have a fifth wave extension, and we are almost near the higher end of this trend channel. Yes, we are almost near this. So in case the market wants to continue extending for a few more days, maybe one more week, then we can test the higher end of this trend channel, which is near 14,700, and then reverse the trend. We might reverse the trend from tomorrow onwards, but I'm not saying we will reverse unless and until we break the swing high of 14,256. So that's my level to conclude whether market is going to reverse or market is going to continue high, go higher. Yes, it can keep stretching little higher in wave 5 if we are going for extension. So wait and watch for a clear-cut trend reversal. And yes, definitely, I've given you the levels. Don't look for resistance on upside, rather look for the support below which we can precisely say market is going for a trend reversal. So now that level is 14,256, they swing high. So wait and watch for a breakdown below it. If you like this video, you can share with your friends. Follow me on Twitter. Subscribe to this free blog. Yes, and subscribe to this free YouTube channel. And keep sharing and keep loving us. I have also started writing on my blog Trendonomics. Recently, I have shared one post on the stages of investor psychology. So go through this. This is the most important post and one must understand the psychology, because after all, markets, reading the market is reading the investor sentiments, reading the psychology and not just charts. So what do you think? Where are we? Whether this is just excitement, thrill or euphoria, which stage we are, or we are still in the early stage optimism? What is it? What do you think? So just go to the blog Trendonomics. I am also giving the link in description. And then comment in the comment box which stage do you think we are in. So that's it for today's update. Keep loving and keep sharing and keep learning. This is Harsh Dixit signing off. Until we meet again.